guys, welcome back to my channel. My name is Christian. If it's your first time seeing me, go ahead and like this video, because girl, I know you're gonna like it already. Okay, subscribe and turn on those post notifications so you never miss another upload. And if you already are subscribed, then hey girl, welcome back. So today, guys, we are going to be talking about a week in spirit. But before we get into that, girl, I have to tell y'all about Etsy, bitch. So Etsy has suspended my account. Etsy has suspended the Pixie Pre-Roll page. Apparently, you're not supposed to sell smokable herbs on Etsy, but y'all know as well as I do that they got plenty of people that sell smokable herbs on Etsy, girl, but they decided to suspend me. What the fuck ever, but whatever. So I have refunded all orders that didn't get sent out. I have personally refunded all of those orders. So if you haven't gotten a refund yet or an email, contact Etsy. Do not contact me. I refunded you. That's all I can do. So contact Etsy, and I am going to be setting up a new store today so you guys will be able to shop. If you guys want updates or whatever, make sure you follow me on Instagram. That's where I put all of the updates about the shop. But I'll probably do a story time maybe about how all of this has been going down, because they literally suspended me while I was out of town. I had to refund everybody, and Etsy was taking the refunds out of my own pocket, literally money I didn't even get from y'all yet. So it's been a lot, but I am basically done refunding everybody finally. So y'all are going to have y'all tea. Y'all should be seeing it soon. And if you haven't got anything yet, again, contact them. But the website will be up. So I wanted to let y'all know that, just a little announcement that has been blowing me. But God is good. We are doing good. We are going to be fine. And we are going to bounce back. So yeah, fuck Etsy though. But yes, so let's go ahead and get into this video, guys. I wanted to basically give you guys a week in spirit, a weekly kind of game plan that you guys can do if you're new to spirituality, or if you kind of just want to have a week, you know, where you're focused on your spiritual healing, focused on your spiritual goals. Especially since we have, you know, this new year coming up, a lot of people have, you know, New Year's resolutions and things like that, or people, you know, just want some new energy, they want to release some shit. So we about to release it, okay? We're about to get it together. And y'all know next year I want to do a lot of, you know, programs like this with you guys. I'm gonna do a week of chakra work as well, so I want y'all tuned in, I want y'all tapped in. So we are about to go ahead and get into our week in spirit. Now this is going to be all about, you know, kind of just when you're first getting into spirituality, but I feel like anybody can use this to get into, you know, some new tea and get a little bit deeper in their journey. So we're going to go through the 7 days. You guys can start this on a Wednesday, a Tuesday, a Sunday, whatever you want to. So we're going to go through the 7 days, and yes, I'll basically explain what you can do as a beginner and what you can do as someone who's a little bit further on their journey, because I do have people here who are a little bit further on their journey and they be asking me about, you know, just different types of things. So yes, we can go ahead and get into it. If you're interested in a week of spirit, a week of spiritual work and healing, then just keep on watching. So guys, first things first, the first day that we have is research. So on the day one of our spiritual week, we're going to be researching. Researching is going to be watching my YouTube videos, researching on your own, watching other videos, going to a spiritual store and talking with someone, possibly getting a reading and being able to research on that feedback. Whatever you can do that is acquiring knowledge. I always say whenever you want to start something new in your journey or take a new path or just, you know, get a little bit deeper, you want to start with research, okay? Figuring out all you can, asking questions, figuring out, you know, what you want to get into, what you want to take, you know, from what you're tapping into. So the first thing you want to do is make sure that you are researching. So again, watching videos like mine, watching somebody else, tuning into somebody's live. Sometimes people do live streams and they ask questions. So figure out what you're looking for right now in your journey. What do you want? Are you looking for answers? Are you looking for clarity? Are you looking for healing? Are you looking for strength, confidence? Are you trying to start a new business? Are you ready for marriage? Are you ready for children? What are you basically trying to achieve right now that makes you think, okay, I need a week of spiritual work. I need a week, you know, to achieve these goals. I want a week where I'm just refreshing. So figure out whatever you're trying to achieve and basically get into the research and basically tap into whatever you can to figure out how you can get into those energies. So we're going to start off with research and knowledge, because that's the biggest thing. People always ask me a bunch of different questions about my journey, and I research, I look into stuff. People ask me how I know this stuff. I research it, I read books, I look into articles, I look at, you know, other spiritual women that I love and that I admire. I learn from other people who have been where I am. So it's all about research and tapping into information around us. So the first day is research, okay? That's for beginners, or if you're a little more intermediate, what's the next step for you? What are you trying to tap into next? So I am a tarot reader. You guys know I'm a spiritual influencer as well. I do this work for you guys here on YouTube. So something new that I could be doing is, let's say I wanted to get into palm reading, or I wanted to get into, you know, like a different type of divination. If I wanted to, you know, start using, you know, a pendulum in my work, different things like that, I would need to research those things. Where do they come from? What's the history? How do you learn how to use those things? How do you get tapped in to that energy? So we always want to start with research. Day two is going to be journal and meditation, okay? I always suggest people to journal and meditate whenever they're first getting into their spiritual journey, but this is good for whenever you're adding new things to your arsenal as well. So you can journal and start to meditate, and that's just allowing you to kind of spend some time with you. After you've researched and check into, after you've researched and look into the new things that you want to take on your journey with you, I think it's good to kind of check in with yourself a little bit. See how you feel about the research. Do some journaling for a few days, a little meditation. If you want to do a spiritual bath on day two, fine. But just take some time to kind of check in with you and figure out how do you feel as a result of this. As all the research that we've done on day one, now we're here to journal and meditate on it and figure out what am I going to pull from this information? What does the information say to me? What speaks to me? Another good thing too is figuring out what calls to you in information. Sometimes I'll look at something and it won't really attract me, but something else will really catch my attention. So it's like doing my research, I figured this out. This really caught my attention. It's like, how do you feel about these energies moving forward? And now that you have these new energies, what do you want to do with them? Okay, so journaling and meditating is good for tapping back in with you. And again, if you're somebody that's intermediate or you're advanced in your journey, you're a little bit further, it's the same thing. Take some time to journal and meditate and figure out, now that I found out this new stuff, I've discovered where I want to go next, how do I feel about that? What is that going to mean for me? How is that going to change from the last time I journaled? How is that going to, differentiate between the last time I meditated? What is new about me now and about my journey since I've discovered what I have discovered yesterday? So yes, some journaling and meditation on day two to tap in with you. The third day, we are going to work on planning and goals. Okay, so that third day, we're going to be taking what we got on day one and day two, putting them together and figuring out, now what am I going to do with this? What are my goals and what am I trying to tap into as a result of the things that I have discovered? So we'll be deciding what we want to do with the new information that we have tapped into. So how does that affect your new goals? How does that affect where you're going and your new plans for your future? So think about your spiritual goals and basically make a plan. It could be 30 days, 60 days, 90 days, whatever you want to do with the energies and the new things that you've discovered. Basically make a plan about how to incorporate those into your everyday life and what you're going to do with that information, the action and the strategy moving forward. On day four, we are going to work on discovery, okay? This is going to be us looking within ourselves and figuring out what is holding us back from where we're going next. Do we need to release some insecurity? Are there some self-doubt? Do we need to research a little bit more? Do we need to network with people who are doing that same thing? Do we need to change, some of our habits? Do we need to remove some things from our routine? Basically figuring out what we need to do to make sure we're able to meet those goals. So the day before, we set the goals, and today we're going to be seeing how we need to make those goals come into the palm of our hand, okay? We also have release for the next day. So on day five, y'all know I got my notes down here, okay? So on day five, we're going to be releasing. So whatever you discovered the day before, we're going to be releasing those things on day five. So we're going to be figuring out, basically how to get those things out of our energy. If we discovered some insecurity, if we discovered that we need to change some things in our space, change some things in our routine, now is the day for us to put those things into action and release those things that we need to. If we have to do a cord cutting, if we have to do a spiritual cleanse of our space, if we have to do a spiritual cleanse of ourselves, whatever we need to do, we're going to be releasing on day five and getting ourselves ready for the last few days and, just ready to wrap up these things. We've discovered what we want to tap into. We've done the journaling and the meditation. We've also worked on figuring out what we need to take care of, like what is stopping us from getting to the next level. And now that we've known those things, we've tapped into it, we can release them. After we release on day six, we are going to be manifesting on day six. So day six is basically to manifest whatever you want to basically now. So the things that you are researching and looking into, basically that was what were you trying to achieve? What, was your goal? What was the thing you were interested in? You didn't just decide, I'm going to look into spirituality today. It's like, no, why are you looking into it? And what are you looking into it for? So the same thing that had you going on day one, go ahead and work on manifesting on day six. So candle magic, doing some scripting, whatever the case may be, doing, some quantum jumping with the 2-cup method, whatever the case may be, doing some manifesting. And I think I have a video about manifesting for beginners if you guys want more manifestation tips and stuff like that. But you guys can do a scripting method. You could write out your manifestation. You could do a vision board on day six. Just have something that you're basically manifesting. Do some manifesting work on that day, because the day before you released anything that was holding you back from doubting your manifestations or doubting your new step, doubting your new journey, doubting your new skill. So now in this space where you have nothing holding you back or making you doubt yourself from your abundance, we can finally manifest these things. So go ahead and we're going to manifest on day six. And on day seven, we are going to be resetting and just showing some gratitude on day seven. So I feel like day seven is probably the most important day, you know, after a very long week of, you know, work and discovery and journaling and meditation, you know, just a week of constantly doing the work, a week of getting into it. On the seventh day, we can rest. We can show gratitude for the things that we have coming to us. And also, we're going to be thinking about the things that we've manifested on day six, putting those things into practice and remembering that these things are coming to us already. We've already done the work. We've already sent that energy out there with those beautiful manifestations. So now in this space, we can know that we're moving forward and know that we're moving on the right path. So yes, that's basically what I have for you guys for a week in spirit. Again, on day one, we're going to be researching what are we trying to get into, what has sparked our interest, why do we even feel like we need a week of work, okay, why are we trying to, you know, what are we trying to do, what are we trying to get into. We're going to research on day one. On day two, journal and meditation, tapping into you and figuring out how that research is going to impact you moving forward. On day three, we're going to work on our planning and our goals. We're going to be putting those things into practice and figuring out, now that we've reflected and seen how these things can affect us, what do we want to do with these things in the future, and how are we going to use these things to our benefit. Okay, we're also going to work on some discovery with day four, figuring out what is holding us back from those goals that we want to tap into. Basically, simply, what's holding us back from those goals? The next day, we're releasing it. Whatever is holding us back, whatever we need to release, whatever can't come with us to the next step, we're getting us out of our space and we're moving past it. So the next day, we can manifest and bring out some beautiful energies that we have been waiting to tap into. And of course, on day seven, we're going to be showing some gratitude to the universe and to God for blessing us with the things that we have wanted and the things that we have tried to attain. I also tell you guys on day one to set the intention that the work is going to work. You're going to see the fruits of your labor. You're going to be able to tap into what you want to tap into and really reap the benefits of the things that you're going to be working on in this season. So yes, that is what I have for you guys for the week in spirit. I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and I hope you guys try, you know, the week of work. I hope it's incredible for you. You know, we have the end of the year wrapping up, so, you know, I might do some work as well just to figure out, you know, what new tea I want to get into for the next year. So yes, I love you guys. Thank you guys. As always, we are almost at 14,000 subscribers. Girl, what the fuck? We literally just hit 13,000 like a week ago. It was literally December 10th, a week ago, when we hit 13,000. We're about to hit 14. I love you guys. Y'all are amazing. Y'all are incredible. And yeah, I'm just ready to keep growing with you guys and expanding. Like I said, next year we got a lot of stuff going on, and I am going to be making a new website for the Pixie Pre-Rolls today. Again, if you guys want updates for the pre-rolls, go ahead and follow my Instagram, Pageant Queen Pixie, for updates about the pre-rolls and stuff like that. So yes, and if you ordered something and you haven't gotten your money back, or you haven't gotten an email Etsy. Again, they are the ones that are holding y'all money. Okay, so email them and cuss them out, because I have been doing it on my behalf and on your behalf, okay? And they still haven't responded to me. So y'all get in contact with them so we can all be on their ass and so they can handle this business for us. So yes, thank you guys. I love you guys, and have a great day. Bye, guys. Bless.